Hello. Hola. Welcome to Grammy Susie's Storytime, coming to you from Albuquerque, New Mexico. I have a great story to read to you today. I hope you like it as much as I do.
Ni hao, boys and girls. Thanks for coming today. Ni hao? That's how you say hello in Chinese, I think. I could be wrong. Today's story is about something that happened in China. Well, it didn't really happen. It's a story, but it's a story that the Chinese people have loved for a very long time, and there are many variations on this story. So, before I start, I want you to get comfortable because it's also a pretty long story, so Big Bear recommends you have a pillow or two to sit on so you can get nice and comfortable. And I would also like to dedicate this story to my grandsons, Andrew and Zachary, whose parents are Chinese and who, even as little boys, are learning how to speak Chinese. So, let's read the story. The story is Tai Mei and the Magic Brush. And it says it's written by Molly Garrett Bong, but really what she did is she put it in English so we could read it here. Because everybody in China knows this story. Okay, are you ready? I'll be ready as soon as I put on my glasses. Okay. Tai Mei learns to draw. Many years ago, a cruel and greedy emperor ruled over China. His people were very poor. One of the poorest was Tai Mei. Her mother and father were dead, and she lived alone. Every day she gathered firewood and cut reeds to sell in the marketplace. Now, I'm going to give you guys an idea. When you're looking at these pictures, they're almost all black and white. But if you look carefully at each one, you'll find some red in it. And that red is always Tai Mei. So if you get a little restless because the book is long, look for Tai Mei. One day, Tai Mei passed by the school. She saw the teacher painting and stopped to watch. She knew right then that that was what she wanted to do. "Please, sir," she said to the teacher, "I would like to learn how to paint, but I have no money to buy a brush. Would you lend me one?" The teacher turned red with anger. "Beggar girls don't paint," he said. "Get out of here." But Tai Mei had an iron will. She decided to make pictures her own way. Now, when she gathered firewood, she used the sticks to draw animals in the dirt. When she cut reeds, she drew fish on the rocks with her wet finger. Soon she drew so well that her pictures looked almost alive. When people saw her drawings of fish, they thought the fish would swim away. When they saw her pictures of birds, they thought the birds were going to sing. But still, Tai Mei had no brush. Every night, she thought about how happy she would be if she could have one. 2, the magic brush. Tai Mei worked especially hard one day and drew until late at night. She fell into a deep sleep. A woman appeared to her in a dream and held out a brush to her. "This is a magic brush," the woman said. "Use it carefully." Tai Mei took it in her hands. The brush was soft and thick, and the handle was of glittering gold. It felt heavy and good. "Thank you, thank you," she cried. But the woman was gone. Tai Mei woke up. It was dawn. She looked around. Everything was the same. She saw the same dirt floor, the same broken walls, the same straw mat. It had all been a dream. But what was this brush in her hands? Taimei was lost in wonder. She painted a bird. The bird flew up, perched outside her window, and began to sing to her. It was alive. She ran outside and painted a fish. The fish flipped its tail, jumped into the river, and splashed in the water. Taimei was happy. 3, the wicked landlord. Soon Taimei began to use the brush to make things for the poor. For a weaver, she painted a loom. For a farmer, she painted a hoe, a pail, and an ox cart. Before long, a wicked landlord heard about the magic brush. He sent for Taimei. "Paint me a picture," he ordered. Taimei refused. The landlord shut her into an empty stable. That night, it began to snow. It snowed for 3 days. "Now she is cold and hungry," thought the wicked landlord. "Now she will paint for me." He unlocked the stable door. Taimei was sitting in front of a warm stove eating hot cakes. They smelled delicious too. The landlord shook with rage. He ordered 6 strong men to kill the girl and bring him the magic brush. Taimei heard the men coming. She painted herself a horse and galloped away down the road. The landlord and his men mounted their horses and galloped after her. They were coming closer and closer. Taimei stopped her horse. She jumped down and painted a big net on the road. The horses rode into it, and the men were tangled in the ropes. Taimei tied up the net and rode away. 4, the evil emperor. Taimei rode on for days and nights until she came to a distant town. She decided to paint pictures and sell them in the marketplace, but she knew it would not be safe to let people know she had a magic brush. She painted birds without beaks and foxes with 3 legs. Because the pictures were not whole, they could not come to life. No one found out what the magic brush could do. One spring day, Taimei painted a crane and left out its eyes, as usual. But as she passed the brush over the picture, 2 drops of ink fell onto the bird's head. What do you think is going to happen? They became eyes. The crane opened them, lifted its wings, and flew off over the marketplace. Everyone stared after the bird. Now the secret was known. The emperor was told, and he sent his officers to bring Taimei to court. Taimei knew that this emperor was greedy and cruel to the poor. She hated him. "Paint me a dragon," the emperor commanded. Taimei painted a toad. "Paint me a firebird," he commanded. Taimei painted a rooster. The rooster crowed and flew onto the emperor's head. The toad hopped onto his belly. And all they flew and hopped all over the palace and left their droppings everywhere. The whole palace stank. The emperor was furious. He grabbed the magic brush and had Taimei thrown into prison. Uh-oh, she doesn't have her brush. 5, the emperor tries the brush. The greedy emperor tried to use the brush himself. He painted a big gold brick, but it was too short. He painted another. It was still too short. Then he painted a long, 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 long golden brick, as long as a whole scroll of paper. At once, the golden brick became a golden python. That's a kind of snake. It opened its red mouth and slid toward the emperor. The emperor fainted, and the snake disappeared. The emperor woke up and trembled. The emperor set Taimei free and begged her to paint for him. He promised her gold and silver. He promised her silks and jewels. He promised her a handsome prince. Taimei pretended to agree. "What would you like me to paint?" she asked. The emperor thought about this. He was still very greedy. He wanted something big, but he was also afraid. If he asked for a mountain, wild beasts might come out of it and eat him up. "Paint me the ocean," he commanded. Taimei painted the ocean. It was wide and calm and smooth as a jade mirror. The water was so clear the emperor could see the very bottom. "Why are there no fish?" he asked. Taimei made a few dots. The dots became fish of all the colors of the rainbow. They wiggled their tails, splashed back and forth, and swam slowly out to sea. The emperor watched happily. "Paint me a boat," he commanded. "I want to sail out and watch those fish." Taimei painted a great ship. The emperor and empress, the princes and princesses, and all their royal court went on board. Taimei painted a few strokes. A breeze blew. Ripples appeared on the water, and the ship moved out. 6, the storm. The ship sailed too slowly for the emperor. He stood on the bow and called to shore, "Make the winds grow stronger, stronger." Taimei painted a few strokes. A strong wind began to blow, and the sea grew rough. Taimei painted on. The wind howled. The waves rose higher, and the ship began to roll. "Enough wind," the emperor shouted. "Enough, enough." Taimei paid no attention. The winds blew into a terrible storm and drove the ship across the ocean to a lonely island. The ship crashed on the rocks, and the emperor and his court almost drowned. No ships came to the island, and they were never rescued. They had to work hard every day and were poor for the rest of their lives. The story of Taimei and her magic brush was told throughout the land. But what became of her? No one knows for certain. Some say that she returned to the village where she was born. Others say she still walks from place to place and paints for the poor wherever she goes. Can you find her in this picture? What do you think happened to Taimei? That's our story for today. And, you know, we read a lot of stories here on Storytime. And the thing about the pictures is they're always magic. They always bring the story to life, if you listen closely enough. Bye. Thanks for coming today. I hope you like the story. Thank you.